Hi, welcome to Able's Tutorials. Today we're going to learn how to make this pencil and how to give it a 3D effect. So let's get started. Go ahead and create this graphic. Let's open a new document. There we go. Let's select the rectangle tool. Let's create some three rectangles. Select this, duplicate. Select the top two points and just pull in these corners so that we have a nice eraser shape on top. Select these two and just clone it like so. Let's make a few circles. Just keep it in the middle. Hold on the Alt key again. They shouldn't be overlapping, so I just need to reduce this a bit. There we go. You can see the pink guides are telling me exactly what to do. I'll go select all, remove the fill. And now I'm going to select this magic tool right here, the shape builder tool. And now I'm going to go ahead and carve out my pencil, so to say. Okay. So hold down this Alt key, and it gives, you can see, it gives a minus sign below the arrow. So all you need to do is click, and the shapes will get removed, like so. And then click outside. Select the pen tool. Let's make a tip. Let's make it from here. Hold down the shift key. And let's make a tip right here. And as I move my mouse, you can see the pink guide, smart guide coming up. That's it, that's what I do. Okay, so we'll just duplicate this, press Control or Command C, and then Control and Command F. So it'll paste right on top, hold down the Alt key, and then just do that. That's it. We'll create another copy of this. Control C, Control F. And for the time being, we'll just drag it down. Yeah. Let's create a box with that. Select all. Little shape in the tool. Press Alt. That's it. Yeah. So now you can. Now you can bring this right up onto that. Okay. So now we have a pencil ready. Now we just need to open our color themes. There we are. Let's select a nice select monochromatic colors. For this one, select a red pencil I have. Add to swatches, let me open my swatches window as well. There they are. And now select the color for the eraser. Darker shape. Okay. Select that as well. And now we need to select the color of the food on the pencil. Make this select shades. Yeah, that sounds good. So let's do that again. So now we're gonna select drag select this and right click and we'll send it to back. Send to back there. Cool. So now let's select our pencil colors. Let's go with this. This can be about this color, this can be black to red, or if you want you can make this red, now that is fine. This can be a little darker, and this is cool, okay. Make this about the wood colors, select this. Make this a little shinier. Select the outer rim. So make that black. Select the inside. Make that soft. So we have a kind of a child on the pencil. And select this. Let's select the orange. Select the big one and make that a little darker. Select this. Yeah, there we go. Let's select all and remove the lines. There we have a pencil. Okay. We'll select this. Now we're going to make a brush. We'll just drag this into the brush library. Select Art Brush. Press OK. And we'll stretch it between guides. So what happens is, it will stretch only between these two guides. And my shape of this shape and this will be intact, and that's it. That's all I have to do. You can keep this outside for the time being. Yeah. Okay. So let's close these windows. We'll go and select the polar grid tool. Hold on option and shift and drag from the center. If I press the down arrow, I can decrease the circles. If I press the up arrow, I can increase the circles. So let's go ahead and increase it a bit more. Yeah. And same if I press the right arrow, I can increase the segments. If I press the left arrow, I can decrease the segments. So let's keep it to this for this exercise, and that's it. Just leave it. Okay, so now we're gonna go and press ungroup and then right click and ungroup again. So now all this is ungrouped, so let's give it weight. Let's make this 0.5 for time being. Yeah. Okay. Now the reason I have these segments here is so that for this exercise, I can just show you exactly where to cut and, you know, not get into calculations of, you know, the bar graph. Let's delete these circles. Let's delete these circles. These are not required. We'll work only on these three. So select this. Select this as a tool here. And give it a cut. Do the same with the other two circles. Yeah. So the outside circle, let's cut it at about 65 degrees. Select the center one, let's cut that at about 50 degrees, no, 180 degrees. This is 270. And let's do this at 45 degrees. Okay. So you can now just delete these unwanted circles. You can delete these lines as well. So there we are. So now we just drag select them, open your brush library, click on the pencil. So all your pencils will come here. So as you can see, this pencil in the middle is the other way around. So what we need to do this here is, you just need to tell this line that which is the starting point of that line. So you have here, you just need to take the pen tool and let's click at one end. That's it. Select all of these. Make go to stroke and make this 0.5. Okay, maybe. So there we are. So we'll select scale, strokes and effects. So what will happen is when I select these, when I select all of these, as you can see, the weight of the line is 0.5. And now when I reduce that, it will also reduce the shape of the pencil. Go ahead and click make a background layer. Let's call that background. Bring it down. Hit Control 0. Give it a gradient. Select the line there. Okay, so now we just need to select that. Select some color from here. So that's it. So now let's go ahead and lock this. pencils a little to the side, and now let's give them a little shadow. So we'll just go give them a drop shadow like so. You can press preview so that you know what's happening around here. Yeah, so now what we need to do is reduce the shadow a bit. Let's make that 45. Let's make these 5 each and reduce the blur to 3. Yeah, that looks good enough, yeah. Now let's lock this, create another layer, let's call this pencils text. So just go ahead and create some text, and let's call this space for headline. Select the font, let's select Helvetica for this. In fact, we can just make this 90%, yeah, and align it. So let's increase, bump up the point size a bit. Four looks fine. And 21, I'm sorry. Make that 24. And reduce the letting a bit, make that 24 as well. Okay. You can choose any font you want. Best grade is for this exercise. So let's do that. And reduce the font size here. Make it 9 on 10. We can just go ahead and fill the placeholder text. Just increase that a bit. Now fill it with placeholder text. The same for this. Let's call this. Hold this down, it'll all be in caps. Item 1. Let's make this bold. Let's duplicate that and release that. Can just fill it someplace on the text. Yeah. So let's not make that bold, let's make that regular 9 points. Hold on shift and move, so it'll move faster. Let's duplicate all that, bring it here. Make that item 2, item 3. Same way, let's duplicate this. Oopsie. Make that that was 45%. Bold. reduce the color of it. Black is we need to start from swatches. Let's make that 45. So this is about, this is 60% black. Hold on the Alt key, duplicate that, and duplicate that again. So 65, 50. So that's it, folks. There you have your graphic ready. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell button for more alerts. More coming your way soon. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.